The image that we'll be analyzing is Xiao Ying trying to swipe the Lanting Scroll by Yan Li Pe. This painting illustrates five figures with a hierarchy of social statuses. Old monk Bian Cai, seated on high chair, his disciple standing alongside him, and across him sits the conniving Xiao Yi. Bian Cai's attendants are depicted to be excluded, preparing tea for guests. Xiao Yi is an official under Emperor Taizong during his reign of Tang Dynasty. He was given the mandate to acquire Lanting Scroll from the monk Bian Cai, who had the original painting by Wang Xizhi, the calligrapher admired most by the emperor. Xiao Yi appeared to Bian Cai dressed as an ordinary scholar not related to the central government, and the two got along very well. The painting depicts Bian Cai seated on a yoke-back chair and Xiao Yi on a wooden bench. Bian Cai's attendants are either bending down or seated on a smaller mat, signifying a lower social status. The migration of Buddhism developed the high seat culture as reflected during the period of enlightenment of Buddha himself. He was resting upon a raised platform signifying a higher status, and this consequently influenced the culture of honorific seats for higher officials, religious dignitaries, and respected guests. Xiao Yi being offered a seat signified him as a respected guest. This culture influenced and reinforced the social hierarchy during the Tang Dynasty. It is also safe to assume Bian Cai's attendants are preparing tea, as a tea grinder is illustrated on the table beside them. In Lu Yu's Tea Classic, he provided a very detailed description of a formal tea ceremony, utilizing 27 different pieces of tools, significant specially to Buddhism disciples due to their relevance to Buddhism teaching. Tea helped to facilitate alertness, right actions, and pure thoughts in the pursuit towards enlightenment. Tea was also more pertinent than alcohol due to the dangers associated with alcohol intoxication. The health benefits alongside the skills and tools needed to prepare tea thus highlighted how tea cultivated elegance and bridged the differences between monks and literati. Additionally, through Lu Yu's description of utensils required for boiling and drinking tea, he highlighted and set the basis for the significance of material culture, or in this context, teaware in tea ceremonies. The illustration of tea served in a bowl depicts the process of traditional tea preparation, boiled and served as a soup. The most noticeable teaware was the yueware, which was first developed during the Han Dynasty and reached its zenith during the Tang Dynasty, where it became the most used ceramic. These yueware were celadon glazed porcelain clay items, which are greenish or olive in color. The highest quality yueware was often chosen as tribute to the royal family and prized by religious connoisseurs. To understand the context of the picture, it would have been better to depict tea being brewed in a monastic setting in the 7th century. However, the background showcases space, a feature of the Tang painting. The background is blank and there is some arrangement of figures and chairs. The emptiness of the space thus allows viewers to appreciate the atmosphere of solitude and zenness.